In his music, I find a lot of sadness.
Violist Rivka Golani.
Not sadness that brings tears to one's eye. It's more philosophical. And I think that's what I see in Brian as well. Maybe I touch a very sensitive subject, but I think we all have a bit of that. It has a lot to do with our history of hardships.
The history that Golani shares with Cherney is the history of the Jews and its central tragedy, the Holocaust. An entire wall of his studio is filled with books on the subject, and he's drawn to any newly available material about it.
Why it affects me so much as a human being at such a powerful level, I don't know. I can't tell you that. I guess there's another dimension that connects with, and that's the whole question of spirituality and what it means and how you relate to a God after the Holocaust. Where was God, and what is the role of God, and is there a role in human affairs? There are so many different aspects of it. It certainly affected my work because, I mean, in many, many ways, I mean, it is an outlet for certain things that I experience and feel, of course, although I'm not turning that into programmatic music, but it's transformed in some way into sound.
Cherney barely knew Rivka Golani when he appeared in a rehearsal studio with a manuscript.
When Brian came, he had something in hand, and he told me, "I brought you something." And this was the solo piece, the Shechina. And he asked me very gently whether I had relatives in Auschwitz. And unfortunately, I had to say yes. Shechina, the word Shechina, represents the female spirit in the Kabbalah, which is one of the main mystical and philosophical books in Judaism. And the story with Shechina was that Brian saw a photograph in one of the papers of children in Auschwitz.
My attention was drawn to this taller, younger woman in the foreground who's holding, you can see that she's holding on to the woman beside her, and it's quite striking. Something about this woman leapt off the page, and I thought, well, probably she's anonymous, and she was probably gassed immediately because she was with children. What I imagine was that she was, her soul was not at peace, and that it was sort of scurrying around from one place to another looking for peace. So the first part of the piece, in fact, is very active and restless and constantly moving around. And then, of course, because she was a young woman, I thought of the connection with Schubert's Death and the Maiden, and so I used that. Then the whole thing just sort of dissolves, disintegrates, as if her spirit is floating off somewhere.